Saiba from XPRO. Today I'll talk about how you can present your content without crowding up your web pages. Well, with the free XPRO content toggle widget for Elementor, you can easily display information in an organized way. You can also use this widget to switch between two kinds of content. But that's not all. This content toggle widget comes with 6 amazing layout styles to make your toggle button more appealing. You can also add an attractive and functional toggle button to showcase multiple portfolios, like personal and commercial. Along with that, you can also style active and inactive toggle buttons with multiple customization options, or showcase your old and new features, or you can also show what your clients and team members say about you. Here, you can see how this toggle button works for pricing plans. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create this one from scratch. So now, without any further ado, let's jump right into it. Head over to our Elementor editor, search the widget name from here, and simply drag and drop the widget onto our canvas. This is the default view of our content toggle button. First of all, I'll add a label to my toggle button from here, as I'm going to write monthly plan here. Next, from the content source, you can either select the editor to add text, or you can use saved templates or dynamic content so that you can add any module here or can easily edit it. I'll choose dynamic content here. Now from here, let's edit the content. You can use this pricing module here if you want, but as I've already made the pricing table on another site, so I'm going to paste this one there by using XPRO cross domain copy paste feature by simply using XPRO copying and pasting the section for the pricing table here. Now update, and there we have it. Now let's go to the secondary section. Similarly, I'll write a yearly plan here and choose a dynamic source. Now let's edit the content and paste the pricing table here. From here, you can also customize this pricing table and can add multiple modules here. And that's it. Now the content is almost done. As you can see from this, users can easily get an idea of your pricing packages and plans, right? Now the next one is my favorite part. Let's do some styling of our widget. From the switch section, you can select from 6 different layout styles. Let's try this one, or maybe this one. This looks good. Now, next is the alignment. You can adjust it to right, left, center. All right. Now, set the size to 40 and space between the text and toggle button to 50 or maybe 30. 30 looks good. Next, we'll play around with the colors that will work well with our website's theme. Here, I'll select the controller color to this, background color to this, and similarly for the secondary button, you can choose any color of your choice, as I'm gonna select white for the controller color, and for background color, this, right? Next is label section. From here, you can select different font styles, as I'm going to select my favorite font, Poppins, right? Next, we can adjust the size of the text to 18. Here, we also have some font styling options, as you can see here. You can adjust them according to your preferences. Next, we can select primary and secondary active colors of text to make your toggle button more attractive or engaging, like this. And that's it. Now let's go ahead and see what it looks like. Wow, I think we probably make it perfectly. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more great content, and hit the bell icon so you won't miss our informative tutorials. And thanks for joining us today.